Hello, everybody. It's summer, so therefore, crop top. It's still awful though, because it's like if I were to go out shopping now, I feel like I'd have to put on like an extra layer before I felt like presentable to the world. Which is bullshit, really, because when you actually get down to the store or wherever it is you're going, you'll find men in this weather walking round in a pair of shorts and flip-flops and nothing else. So, you know, it's just like, aw, but I wanted to freeze my tits off in the freezer section. How come they can only do it? In the meantime, am putting a hoodie on and I'm sat there going, I'm dying, I'm just boiling. I'm gonna die of heat exhaustion before I get to go anywhere. And do you know what? The problem isn't really sort of anybody's perception of you. It's not my perception of myself that's the problem here. It's like, I would be quite happy to walk around like this if I were able to get away with it. But if I were going shopping in particular, or any place where I felt like I could be hemmed in, I tend to put an extra layer on because of the perverts. I know, it's awful. I have had problems in the past whereby I have quite literally been followed around stores, by perverts who just want to invade my personal space, you know, like I'm part of their shopping experience. It sounds like it's going to be a huge rant, and it is kind of a rant, but it's a rant with a happy ending. So, I mean, I do horrible, horrible things to the perverts who follow me around. Okay? To the point whereby I reckon a part of them wishes that they hadn't fucking tried it. For example, I once went to a bookstore and discovered that all the computer games magazines were lumped in with the men's magazines. Now, this is quite a common occurrence and I wish it wasn't, because it puts people like me at a huge, huge risk from perverts. You know, it's not in like the hobby section. You know, it's lumped in with men's interests, you know, because apparently only men can understand what computers are. Duh. You know, it's a very, very old-fashioned view that I honestly, you know, when I speak to people who play video games, I meet very, very, very few people who actually hold that belief. I've not encountered it. It must be a purely internet phenomena where this has come from, or the poor unfortunate sods who just so happen to live in very, very sexist communities. And obviously, all of those people appear to work in bookstores, you know, when they're arranging things, it's like, oh, men's interest. So anyway, they put all these magazines on the bottom shelf, which was great, because, you know, if there's one thing that I hate more than a fucking sexist bookshop, it's a heightist bookshop. You know, you sat there on your little tippy-toes trying to reach up to the top shelf. So anyway, I bend down to look at this magazine, and from behind me I just hear, I was like, Jesus Christ, I'm about to be surprise raped by Darth Vader, what the fuck? And he's just, at first I think that it's just a guy with like asthma or something, but then I can feel him getting closer. And it's the point where, because of how the shelves were arranged, the lads' mags overhung where the computer games mags were. So I was sort of being practically pushed into this shelf, and I was just like with my face pressed up against the glass going, hang on a fucking second. And he gets so close, I can quite literally feel the heat radiating from his groin. So I was just like, oh yeah, up a bit, left a bit. Fuck off! Well, that was one way of getting out of it, but it's not the cruelest thing I've ever done to a pervert. The worst thing I ever got was a pervert who actually followed me around a supermarket, and he was unrelenting, this pervert. Now, everybody thinks about perverts, and you know, despite all the stereotypes being well crushed by now, we still have that vision of, like, you know, this old creepy man with about four teeth and an overcoat and, like, really long greasy hair. Well, this guy, you know, when I actually looked at him, he looked really, like, quite middle-aged, middle-class and very, very respectable. I wasn't wearing anything out of the ordinary. It was just like a pair of jeans and a t-shirt or something. But this guy followed me everywhere. It was like a horror film. Everywhere I went, he was just like right there, like right beside me. And I was just like, Jesus fucking Christ. I tried to escape him. I tried to give him the slip, but every time I thought I got rid of him, he'd turn up like right behind me. And he always wanted whatever product I just so happened to be standing in front of. Now, you know, sometimes if people are blocking up, like, you know, a shelf that you really need to get to, and you go, sorry, excuse me, and they go, oh, sorry, and they pull their trolley to one side. This didn't happen, okay? This guy would just lean over me, so his arm would just come sailing over my shoulder and sort of ghost boy face as he sort of reached for whatever it was, and I was just like, what the fuck is this? You know, and you pull away and you go like, ugh. Just like, but their disgust actually makes, your disgust at them makes them follow you around more. Why? Anyway, we get to the checkout and horror upon horror, I discover that he's standing in the queue behind me with his wife. His poor wife looked, she had a face on her like thunder. Because I bet that he'd been doing this shit all day, and it's just like, I thought he'd grow out of this crap. But obviously not, and there's nothing cute about what he's doing, and there's nothing funny about what he's doing, but in return, she was fucking driving him into the ground, okay? She was like very, very prim, very, very proper, you know, very respectable, very no-nonsense, and every move this guy make, it was just like, why are you unpacking that? Stop doing that. Oh God, don't do that. Just shut up and don't talk to me, okay? In short, I really, really liked her. So, I knew what I was about to do. So I waited until I got to the head of the queue. I just did everything normal. I could feel him like inching closer and closer, and his wife's just like, why did we have to use this checkout? You know, and I was just like, you know, I was just like, why'd you think? Because I'm standing here. She was just really confused and she had no idea why he had made them use this checkout. It was obviously to just stay with me for as long as possible and just to get the whole creep experience in. Anyway, I was done being disgusted at it because now I'd seen this little weed for what he really was. He wasn't actually going to do anything. I wouldn't have done this to absolutely any pervert, but I knew that with this particular one, I'd be able to get away with it. So I waited until I paid, and I packed up all my stuff. I got together all my bags, make sure that everything was done and dusted. And just as we were about to leave, and he's still unpacking, I lean over the counter at him, and I just go, call me. And leave. Well, the next thing I hear is, ah! It was the naughtiest thing I'd ever done, but it was so worth it.